فخری رسول محبوب خدا محمد رسول اللہ.
نبی علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام said, if his heart had the fear of Allah, the khashiyat of Allah, then you would see his body would have the khashiyat. Because his heart is not connected to Allah, he has no khashiyat and khawf in his heart. That's why he's playing with his beard now, even though he's standing in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La khashiyat qalb, if his heart has the fear of Allah, khashiyat of Allah, if it is humble in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will see his body is going to be humble as well. The heart and the body are connected. There's no fear in our hearts. We live in a day and age where the world wants to make you independent. It's trying to free you from religion, free you from Allah. This is the world we live in now. It's trying to make you think that it's you. So it's given you flashy cars. It's given you the dunya. It's given you everything so that you can think it's you. And he wants you to disconnect from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't want you to connect to Allah Almighty. Because those who fear Allah Almighty, those who have true taqwa, look in the history, look in history. Any name that you will mention who feared Allah Almighty, what did they have? They had no maal and dawlat. Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, what maal and dawlat did they have? Bahauddin Naqshband, what did they have? Imam Bishr ibn Harith al-Hafi. Look at Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala an. Umar Farooq had the fear of Allah Almighty. The people who say they fear Allah Almighty, they say it with their tongues. We have become people of our tongues now. Our tongues move a lot. We talk the talk, but brother, we don't walk the walk. We need to start walking the walk. We need to stop talking it. We need to start acting and implementing. And through implementing and acting yourself, you will see that you will help the brother next to you. You begin to help one another. Brother, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wherever you are, whether you are in open, whether you are behind closed doors. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly stated in the Quran, whenever you read the verses of Jannat and Jahannam, you see that's the final destination. You get into your grave, the angels will test you, you will live through that. Your life in the grave is longer than the life you live in this world. You live 60 years here, and you might live 600, 700 until Qiyamah in your grave. So you're living your life thinking you're living here forever, whereas you will be spending more time in your grave. Common sense dictates to me and you, brother. Common sense dictates to me and you. You will prepare for something that you will be longer at, not the one that you are less. We're here for a short period of time. Common sense dictates to me and you that we need to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to prepare for our death. Prepare for something that is longer. That is maut. That is the alamul barzakh. That's the world where the souls will be kept. We need to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more in relation to that. We need to prepare for that more than we need to prepare for anything else. What preparations have you made for death? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam will sit with his companions and Nabi alayhi salam will say, you know who the clever man is? Let me tell you, the clever man ain't he who has the degree. Ain't the one who has he has the PhD. He has the masters. These ain't clever people. They clever for the dunya. They clever people now. You know, the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the people who fear Allah Almighty, they're clever how? They remember death all the time. He's a clever person because he knows, you know what? I ain't gonna live too long. My life's short. One day I will die. One day I will stand in front of Allah Almighty. What face am I going to show Allah Almighty? What face? Ask yourself, what face? If death was to come to me right now, what face will I show to Allah? I've committed so many sins in my life. What face will we show? Tell me. We ain't even ready to stand in front of Allah. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ. The one who fears standing in front of his Lord. وَنْهَا النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ. And he rejects and he rebukes his nafs from the desires. He prevents desires from occurring in his heart. فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَىٰ. For this Kamil Wali of Allah Almighty, for this Mard-e Mujahid, this individual who denounces his nafs and desire, the one who fears that he will stand in front of Allah, فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَىٰ. Jannatul Firdaus is waiting for him. That's the final abode. That's what we have to prepare for. Some people will read Salah because they have to read Salah. Some people will read Salah for Jannatul Firdaus. Some people will read Salah because they're scared of hell. The awliyaullah, they don't read it for heaven, nor do they read it for hell. They only read it for the raza of Allah. They read their Salah for the pleasure of Allah Almighty. Me and you, we are not even on the ladder yet, Ram. We are not even on that ladder. Who do we read our Salah for? We haven't even taken the step. Our intentions are corrupt even before we read the Salah. When we're in the Salah, Shaitan wakes up and says, now think, what are you going to eat tomorrow? Oh, I need to go here. You know, those appointments you couldn't remember out of Salah, in Salah he reminds you. Shaitan has a diary of what you will do. He knows your life better than you know it. Allah Almighty, Habib alayhi salatu wasalam, said, Shaitan runs in the blood of Ibn Adam. He runs in your blood. He's in your system all the time. He has a grasp over your heart. If you do not remember Allah Almighty, He's always over your heart. He's always whispering into your ears. He's always trying to deceive you, misguide you, deviate you from the haq, deviate you from the prostration of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What did Shaitan not do? Shaitan didn't bow down to Allah. Shaitan disobeyed Allah, he didn't bow down. Now if you bow down to Allah, what have you done? You've obeyed Allah. And what does he want to do? He wants you to stop bowing down. He doesn't want you to put your head down for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants to misguide you.